is a world of difference between prophecy and prediction. This one's not prophecy, as been advertised, but actually a prediction of events based on the possible turn out of events. Or again, I would call it environmental prophecy. Anyone can predict this also. Genuine prophets will say it exactly how it will happen, and not by saying if or maybe. My family, I am bringing you this segment because we need to monitor this prophecy by His grace to see the end result. Myself, I feel even knock my chair, say I feel prophesy this one or predict this one correctly, and it will come to pass because it's a known fact that they might give Gaddafi's son because they want peace in Libya and compensate Gaddafi family. And I ask, what is the prophecy here with all these if? A true prophecy is categorically will say this is what will happen, no matter what. Not this plain save by saying if. This one has become something else because there is no more preaching of salvation. Nothing like repentance in your mouth. It's only election prediction. Like for a, how this one even take concern you with Libya matter? You never even see Nigeria finish. You won't enter Libya. Are you on prophetic tourism? Immediately I saw this headline, Gaddafi's son will win presidential election in Libya. What came to my mind is, what of if, except, unless it's provided, would follow it. And I was not disappointed. It came just the way I guess. There must be a safety net to explain away the guess called prophecy if it fails. Hello, my amazing family. Trust the next chapter because you are the author. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time here. Thank you. Gaddafi's son will win presidential election in Libya, Primate Ayodele prophesies. The leader of the INRI Evangelical Spiritual Church, Primate Elijah Ayodele, has released some prophetic revelations on the forthcoming presidential election in Libya. Primate Ayodele revealed that the son of the Libya president, Gaddafi, Saif al-Issam, will win the election, except the poll is influenced by international communities. Same old stories. It said democracy in Libya cannot be truncated or stopped because the set time of the country has come. In a statement signed by his media head Osho Oluwatosi, the clergyman explained that the election will be a surprise to many as people will come out in their numbers to vote, adding that the election will be surprisingly peaceful. He mentioned that there will be an international influence in the election, but in the end, democracy will prevail. On the outcome of the election, Primate Ayodele stated that if there is no serious contender, Gaddafi's son, Saif Gaddafi, will win the election. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is your first time. Thank you. There will be democracy in Libya. Nothing will truncate the democracy in Libya any longer. The election will be tough, and what will happen isn't what people will think. If there is no serious contender to battle with Gaddafi's son, Saif Gaddafi, he will win the election, except there is influence from international communities. The election will be surprisingly peaceful. People will come out en masse, and it will not be a usual business. The next president of Libya will come up as a result of international influence, but there will be a democracy. The set time for Libya democracy is now. Meanwhile, the late Libyan dictator Muammar Gaddafi's son and one-time heir apparent launched his candidacy for the country's presidential election next month on Sunday, Libya's electoral agency reported. According to the outlet, Saif al-Islam filed his candidacy papers in the southern town of Sabah. Gaddafi's son was taken by fighters late in 2011, the year his father was deposed after more than 40 years in power. After a popular revolt, Muammar Gaddafi was later assassinated during the subsequent fighting, which devolved into a civil war. But please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up, especially if this is a first time here. Thank you. Saif, dressed in a traditional Libyan robe, turban, and spectacles, stated in a video broadcast by the elections office where he registered that God will determine the country's future course. Saif al-Islam was released in June 2017 after more than 5 years in detention and revealed in an exclusive interview with the New York Times in July that he was considering a run for the country's top post. Libya's presidential elections are scheduled for December 24th. After years of UN-led efforts to usher in a more democratic future and end the war, the long-awaited vote confronts a number of obstacles, including unresolved election law issues and occasional fighting among armed groups. Other impediments include the country's deep schism between East and West, which has been divided for years by the war, and the presence of thousands of foreign combatants and troops. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up, especially if this is the first time here. Thank you. Gaddafi, the tyrant, was the father of 8 children, the majority of whom served key roles in the dictatorship. His son, Mahtasim, was assassinated concurrently with Gaddafi's detention and assassination. Saif al-Arab and Khamis, 2 further sons, were assassinated earlier in the rebellion. Another son, al-Sayed Gaddafi, was released in September following his extradition from adjacent Niger. We don't hear him from our prophet. Is no longer a local league, it is an international league this time around. So we can't wait for December 24th to come for we to see the outcome of Libya general presidential elections. But please don't forget to give us a like and please hit on the notification button for more authentic news. I remain number 1 on this blog. Thanks for watching. Bye.